हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ न्यू चैप्टर बायो मोलिक्यूल्स एंड इन दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी स्मॉल मोलिक्यूलर वेट ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स इन लिविंग टिश्यूज। नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द डेफिनेशन ऑफ बायो मोलिक्यूल्स। ऑल द कार्बन कंपाउंड्स दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम लिविंग टिश्यूज can be called biomolecules. In living tissues, we can find sugar or carbohydrates, amino acids, fats and oils, and nucleotides, nucleosides, or nitrogen bases. So all these organic compounds we will discuss one by one. Here it is sugar. In the form of glucose or ribose. Glucose structure is C6H12O6 and ribose structure is C5H10O5. Amino acid. In amino acid, functional groups are HCH3 or CH2OH. Depending on functional group, the function of amino acid get differed. Okay, so we will see first amino acid. Amino acid are organic compounds containing an amino group and acidic group as substituents on the same carbon. That is alpha carbon. They are called alpha amino acids. They are substituted methanes. CH3 means methane. There are four substituent groups occupying the four valency positions. These functional groups are hydrogen, carboxyl group, amino group, and a variable group designated as R group. Based on the nature of R group, there are many amino acids. Those which occur in proteins are only of 20 types. The R groups in this proteinaceous amino acid could be hydrogen. Here, if hydrogen is there, then it is called glycine. If hydroxymethyl is present, then it is called serine. CH2OH means hydroxymethyl. And if methyl CH3 group present, then it is called alnine. Hydrogen group, glycine, methyl group, alnine, and carboxy. Hydroxymethyl group, it means serine. Basically, these amino acids are of two types, acidic or basic, depending on amino and carboxy group. So, example of acidic amino acid is glutamic acid, and in basic amino acid there is lysine, or neutral amino acid is valine. There are some aromatic amino acids. The names are tyrosine, phenylalanine, tryptophan. These are the aromatic amino acids. A particular property of amino acid is ionizable nature of NH2 and COOH group. Hence, in solutions of different pH, the structure of amino acid changes. Here you have to remember, hydrogen group means glycine, methyl group means alnine, and hydroxymethyl group means serine. Next is fats and oils or lipids. Lipids, these are the some examples of lipids. They are found in the form of oils or fats. It would be simple fatty acids. A fatty acid has carboxyl group attached to an R group. The R group could be methyl, ethyl, or higher number of CH2 groups. Methyl means CH3, ethyl means C2H5, and higher number CH2, where carbon will range from 1 to 19 carbons. For example, in palmitic acid, 16 carbons, including carboxyl carbon. How many carbons are there? 16. Arachidonic acid, there are 20 carbon molecules. Fatty acids can be saturated or unsaturated. Saturated means without double bond, and unsaturated means one or more carbon to carbon double bond. Another simple lipid is glycerol, which is trihydroxypropane. Many lipids have both glycerol and fatty acids. Here, fatty acids are found esterified with glycerol. They can be monoglycerides, diglycerides, or triglycerides. These are called fats and oils based on their melting points. Oils have lower melting point and hence remains oil in winter. Some lipids have phosphorus group, and based on that phosphoric group, they are called phospholipids. What they call phospholipids? They are found in cell membrane. So, example of phospholipid is lecithin. See here. Here it is lecithin. This is phospholipid because here presence of P. P means phosphorus. Another third type of biomolecules are based on heterogeneous ring structure. For most of these structures, the base is nitrogen. So basically, these nitrogen bases are divided as nucleosides or nucleotides. In nucleosides, we can found adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine, or uracil. When acid word come in the name of that substance, then it is called nucleotide. So, example of acids are adenylic acid, thymidylic acid, guanylic acid, uridylic acid, cytidylic acid. So, these are nucleotides, and nucleosides are adenosine, guanosine, thymidine, uridine, and cytidine. So, you may remember nucleic acids like DNA and RNA consist of nucleotides only. And DNA and RNA, what they do? They are the function and genetic material. Okay? So, in today's lecture, we discuss biomolecules in brief. In that, we discuss sugars or carbohydrates, amino acids, fats and oils, or combinedly called lipids, or nitrogen bases, nucleosides, and nucleotide. So, practice these molecular formulas. Okay, by drawing and writing all the formulae, you have to remember all these names and their types. Either they are basic or acidic or neutral in case of amino acids, or in case of lipids, either they are phospholipids or not, that you have to remember. And in case of nitrogen bases, you have to remember nucleosides or nucleotides. So keep watching, keep studying. Thank you.